Three quick pieces of news for you in today's video. Stay tuned to the end to see new images of interstellar comet 3IALs. First up, if you're in Europe, Africa, Asia, India, Australia, and all points in between, you have a shot at observing a total lunar eclipse tomorrow, September the 7th. For those that can see it, totality will last 1 hour and 22 minutes, and the whole event from Earth's shadow touching one side of the moon to leaving the other side will last 5 hours and 27 minutes. In the image on screen, you can see the path of the eclipse. For more information on this image, check out theskylive.com, who have all the details. Okay, change of pace. Now we're looking at a stunning new image from the James Webb Space Telescope. This star cluster, called Pismes 24, is located in the Lobster Nebula in the constellation Scorpius. You can only see a tiny fraction of the whole nebula in this image. Pismes 24-1 is the bright star right here, and astronomers thought it was a single massive star for a long time. It turns out it's at least two stars in a close orbit. These two stars are absolutely massive. One is 74 times the mass of the Sun and the other 66 times, making them among the most massive and luminous stars ever seen. You might think this image shows the stars rising above a distant mountaintop, but the brown structures are walls of gas and dust being sculpted by the incredibly powerful radiation and stellar winds coming from the cluster of bright, massive stars. For more information, head over to the ESA website where they have a great description of everything you can see in this image. Finally, we have new images of interstellar comet 3I Atlas from the Gemini South Observatory, an 8.1-meter telescope located in the Chilean Andes. As you can see in this image taken on August the 27th, 3I Atlas is starting to develop a tail as it gets ever closer to the Sun and heats up. To me, it looks as though the coma has become more pronounced as well, which is what we expect as the nucleus of the comet is heated by the Sun and the ice there starts to sublimate, turning from frozen ice to gas. As that happens, some of the dust and rock trapped in the comet is also released, so it'll be interesting to see what elements we can detect there and whether these elements differ from what we see in comets that originate in our own solar system. If you're wondering what the multicolored streaks are, those are background stars. The telescope is tracking the comet, and that's moving across the sky much faster than the background stars, so if you focus on the comet and take a long exposure, the background stars will appear like streaks. We'll get much more data on 3I Atlas in the coming weeks as it heads towards its closest approach to the Sun on October the 29th and its closest approach to Earth on December the 19th, although it will still be 167 miles away from Earth on that date. That's today's video. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed it. I will catch you in the next one.